In a campaign-style rally tonight, President Trump touting his achievements in Pensacola, Florida.
How are your 401ks doing? Not too bad, right?
President Trump.
Vote for Roy Moore.
Urging his base to vote for controversial Senate candidate Roy Moore.
The future of this country cannot afford to lose a seat in the very, very close United States Senate. We can't afford it, folks.
President Trump's endorsement, both at the rally and earlier on Twitter, comes despite eight women having accused Moore of inappropriate behavior, including sexual assault. These photos from the Washington Post showing some of the accusers around the time they say they encountered Moore. Many of Moore's accusers say they were teenagers at the time, while he was in his 30s. Moore vehemently denies the allegations.
These allegations are completely false. They're malicious. Specifically, I do not know any of these women, nor have I ever engaged in sexual misconduct with any woman.
I think it's a huge mistake of the president to get involved in a race like this on behalf of somebody like Roy Moore. I think though he may win this one little battle, he's going to lose the war, which is he's going to tarnish his own brand and tarnish the brand of the Republican Party.
Lee Korfman says when she was only 14, a then 32-year-old Moore took her to his home and touched her inappropriately. She spoke on the Today Show.
He basically laid out some blankets on the floor of his living room and proceeded to seduce me, I guess you would say. And during the course of that, he removed my clothing. He left the room and came back in wearing his white underwear, and he touched me over my clothing, what was left of it, and he tried to get me to touch him as well.
I was terrified.
Beverly Young Nelson also claims that when she was 16, Moore groped her and tried to force a sex act on her in his car. She sat down with my colleague, Tom Yamas.
He was trying to pull me toward in between his legs. It was terrible. And I was bound and determined that I was not going to be raped by him.
She first spoke publicly about what she says happened to her last month at a press conference with her powerhouse attorney, Gloria Allred.
He said, "You're just a child." And he said, "I am the district attorney of Etowah County. And if you tell anyone about this, no one will ever believe you."
Nelson says Moore's supporters have called her a liar, even compared her to a criminal since she first spoke out 3 weeks ago.
That really hurt me, you know. God knows, and Roy knows, and I know what happened.
Young's proof that she knew Moore? Her yearbook, she says Moore signed. But Moore and his supporters have called into question the inscription, noting the writing under the signature appears to be different.
Let's look at Beverly Nelson. Everybody knows her yearbook is a forgery.
Nelson does admit that it was she and not Moore who wrote the notes below the inscription, but she still insists that message and signature was all Roy Moore's.
But to be clear, Beverly, he signed your yearbook.
He did sign it.
And you made some notes underneath.
Yes.
Today, Nelson and her attorney underscored that the signature is authentic, offering evidence in a press conference from a handwriting expert.
It demonstrates that when Roy Moore stated, quote, "I do not know any of these women," end quote, that statement does not appear to be true. The signature and the handwritten notation above the signature were prepared by Roy Moore.
Just hours later, the Moore campaign hitting back.
Release the yearbook so that an independent expert, not your paid expert, an independent expert, a neutral third-party custodian, can take it and look at the ink so that we can find out, is the ink a month old or is it 40 years old? The truth is out there, and until she releases the yearbook, all we know is they're not telling the truth.
Polling shows a tight race between Roy Moore and his Democratic opponent, Doug Jones.
Roy Moore has never, ever served our state with honor.
His campaign has been trying to capitalize on the accusations against Moore.
I think the race is within 2 or 3 points with a slight advantage to Roy Moore, the Republican, but it's a race that Doug Jones still has the shot at winning in this race, depending on what the turnout is and how the voters fall.
Doug Jones's team also seizing on this audio from a campaign event originally published in the LA Times, where Moore made controversial comments about slavery when asked, "When was the last time America was great?"
I think it was great at the time when the families were united. Even though we had slavery, they cared for one another. People were strong in the families.
He did go on to praise all the progress the country has made on civil rights and prejudice.
We've done a lot of things to bring this country around. And I think we can still make it better.
Moore's campaign also telling ABC News, of course the judge opposes slavery.
He was going to lose the African-American vote overwhelmingly because of many of his stands on many different issues in the state, in the view of him by many voters, not just African-Americans, but many voters, that he's a throwback candidate to a time that feels more like George Wallace.
Despite everything, many of Moore's supporters are sticking with him.
Well, this is right out of the playbook of dirty politics.
I just don't see how he could be guilty now and not guilty in all these other elections.
I'm sure he's telling the truth.
After initially spurning him, the Republican National Committee recently reversed course, sending resources and contributions to his campaign.
We're not going anywhere.
What do you think about the Republicans that say they believe people like you, but they'd rather have a Republican in that seat than a Democrat?
Is the party more important, really, than what happened? I feel like my incident is being just swept under the rug, literally, because he's a Republican.
All of this comes in the midst of a roiling national debate about sexual misconduct.
In the coming weeks, I will be resigning as a member of the United States Senate.
On Thursday, Al Franken announced he'll resign after 8 women came forward with accusations of sexual misconduct by the Democratic senator from Minnesota.
I am leaving while a man who has bragged on tape about his history of sexual assault sits in the Oval Office, and a man who has repeatedly preyed on young girls campaigns for the Senate with the full support of his party.
The power of the Me Too movement, Time Magazine's Person of the Year, now sweeping through some of Washington's power corridors, but leaving others unscathed.
How do we reckon with that? And is that going to put pressure on Roy Moore? Is Franken going to become an example in Alabama? I think it's too early to tell exactly, except for that this movement is moving so quickly. We didn't see a month ago that this was going to happen.
This weekend, both candidates crisscrossing the state to get the vote out. But Beverly Nelson, a Trump supporter, says this should be an easy choice.
I don't understand why people would want to put him in office, knowing that he has done this more than once to someone else. I just don't understand that. I can't agree with that. I really can't.
This guy's screaming, "We want Roy Moore." He's right. Democrats in Congress want open borders, higher taxes, and government-run health care that doesn't work, cost a fortune, doesn't work. They're soft on crime, and they want to suffocate our economy with socialist-style regulation, raise your taxes through the sky. They don't want to vote for our tax cuts because they want the exact, they want tax increases. That's why we need a Republican in the House. We need a Republican in the Senate. We need more of them. And by the way, just so I can satisfy this gentleman out there, how many people here are from the great state of Alabama? Whoa. Well, I have to say this. Look, we have to be fair. So did you see what happened today? You know the yearbook? Did you see that? There was a little mistake made. She started writing things in the yearbook. What are we going to do? Gloria Allred. Anytime you see her, you know something's going wrong. We cannot afford this country. The future of this country cannot afford to lose a seat in the very, very close United States Senate. We can't afford it, folks. We can't. We can't afford to have a liberal Democrat who is completely controlled by Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer. We can't do it. Can't do it. His name is Jones, and he's their total puppet, and everybody knows it. He will never, ever vote for us. We need somebody in that Senate seat who will vote for our Make America Great Again agenda, which involves tough on crime, strong on borders, strong on immigration. We want great people coming into our country, building the wall, strengthening our military, continuing our great fight for our veterans. I love our veterans. We love our veterans. We want conservative judges like Judge Gorsuch on the Supreme Court, doing a great job, too. We want people that are going to protect your gun rights. Great trade deals instead of the horrible deals. And we want jobs, jobs, jobs. So get out and vote for Roy Moore. Do it. Do it. Do it.